Hey everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Solo Queue Silly on the channel. Today, we're going to be returning as Falstad to take a look at some of the changes that he recently went through. And we're going up against a party of five, split into a party of three, a party of two. But we're not going to talk about that. What we are going to talk about, though, are the changes that have come Falstad's way in the form of the sort of, I guess, anti-auto-attack, anti-right-click build that that Blizzard is a little bit not fond of anymore. So they want Falstad to be more of a caster slash magey class. Or I should say hero, anyway. And I understand the logic, because they want to kind of diversify the amount of builds that their heroes are played as, or with, or through. But Falstad is really, really, really good in the AA department, Blizzard. I'm just saying. I'm not complaining. So what I'm going to be doing today is a little bit of a non-standard right-click build for Falstad. I am going to be primarily making sure that I'm going for the boomerang slash hammering talent that Falstad has. And he's got a couple of neat tricks up his sleeve to kind of increase the amount of damage that he can deal with his Q, which, of course, is the hammerhand. But first, I need to juice steam real quick. So for our team, it's going to be Murky, Li Ming, Murden, Rhaegar, Falstad, taking on the Temuroz, Li Ming, the Butcher, Diablo, and Thrall. Level 1, I'm going to be going for Gathering Storm. Gathering Storm is going to permanently increase the amount of hammering damage that I'm able to deal as long as I hit an enemy hero. That is an enemy hero, not enemy creep, not enemy mercenary, enemy hero. So this is all skill shot, and you know what happens whenever we got to start worrying about skill shots. We got to start, expect to see some missed skill shots is the best thing that I can say. This is the first time I'm playing as Falstad since the change happened. The other big change that came Falstad's way was the difference in damage in the Hinterlands Blast. Now, they didn't do that much of a buff to Hinterlands Blast damage, but they just made it, quote, more impactful. Or at least I feel like they said that it was more impactful. It's been a couple weeks since the patch actually happened. The PAX patch actually happened. For Falstad, but nonetheless, I'm very excited to see how different this version of Falstad plays. And again, I'm under the premise of I really enjoy playing the right click build for Falstad. I think that it's the best way to play him. I think that's what he was built for. Because again, his basic attacks are just so strong. But Blizzard, obviously, they don't really like when it's only like one clear build for a particular hero. And that's exactly what they did. So that's what they did for a lot of the auto attack builds. Is what they even did for Kael'thas. They don't like some of the strength that the Phoenix had. Blah blah blah. But we are not talking about patch notes. We're talking about Falstad. So as you see here, I got the double damage bonus there from Diablo because I did hit him on the backswing and the front swing, which is very good. That's gonna be my primary. Basically, my primary order is this: I'm going to try to deal as much damage as I can back and forth to Diablo without getting myself killed. Now, Diablo is going to have a bear of a time dealing with Falstad, just because of the simple fact that going up against range, and especially against range that has a very, very easy kiteable ability in the barrel roll, I'm honestly not that worried about Diablo. Now, I know that's going to sound cocky. That's going to sound like, oh man, Zendikta thinks he's all-star MLG pro all of a sudden. No. I don't believe that at all. But what I am saying is that I know the difficulties of leaning against a Falstad who liberally uses the barrel roll ability nonstop. Again, barrel roll is it is the life essence. It is the lifeblood of keeping Falstad alive. That is okay. It is all right. We don't have to be happy. We don't have to play a right-click build in order to be happy, Falstad. I know. You weren't born a caster, but by golly, you're gonna try to be the best caster you can be. And again, I totally understand Blizzard's logic on this. I really do. I'm not blaming them one bit. We as fans of the game benefit from there being greater diversity in the amount of builds and the type of builds that the heroes are, that basically the heroes go through. Level 4, I'm going to be going for Power Throw. Power Throw is going to increase the amount of maximum range that the Hammerang goes through, along with increasing the amount of slow that the Hammerang does by 25%. So I'm not going to fly on in here because that would be suicide, and it doesn't really look like no one's going for it, especially since Murden is going down to the bot right now, and we don't even have Rhaegar here. Diablo going way too ham here. I'm going to see if I can get a body block here. And nice job with the S of Johan. Again, I'm gonna try to body block Diablo. We are gonna be able to pick up the kill. So there we go. I'm gonna give myself a nice little pat on the back for that, because that was that Diablo player is pretty annoyed right now, and I totally don't feel bad at all, because that's what Diablo players do to other people. You gotta use your size to bully people sometimes. And Diablo is definitely the biggest dude in the game. I guess Azodan could be technically considered bigger than Diablo. Oh no, I don't know who has the bigger character model actually. Now that I think about it, I think Azodan might be the biggest. So level 6 here, slightly ahead against of our opponents. Very, very close game, very low scoring game so far in the kills department. That's okay. Again, I expect Diablo to not have a fun time. There's the gank attempt there. 3-man gank this time around. I feel very accomplished in that. So let's see if I can get Li Ming. I was trying to get Li Ming on the backswing to get a little bit of extra damage there. Extra stacks on the Gathering Storm here. I'm currently sitting at 12, so it's not too bad. I mean, I don't really have a baseline that I can shoot for with the Gathering Storm talent for Falstad. Again, because I don't play Falstad much, and I certainly don't play this type of build. Because aforementioned, right-click build, yada, 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 you know what I'm saying. I think this Diablo is falling asleep, man. He's taking a lot of damage. I'm not going to pursue him. I did see Li Ming coming over here from this side, so I do have my barrel roll ready just in case I need to get away from Li Ming. That was actually the displacement grenade thrown out by Lieutenant Morales. Did not get the backswing on that. No big deal at all. Level 7, I am going to be going for Boomerang. Boomerang is going to give me a second activation of the Hammerang, which allows me to basically cast and get a... it basically allows me to create an explosion every single time I double tap with the Q ability. I'm going to go back and heal. Not heal, but get mana. Unfortunately, I don't have enough. I don't know how we didn't actually get this tribute, but apparently Murden got completely mollywopped by Li Ming. Murky did not come down here, and Rhaegar died somehow. A little bit of a waste of a fly here. I thought maybe I could get there before Li Ming was able to run away. Or not Li Ming, sorry, Diablo. Li Ming was running away from Diablo. So right now, not looking too good, team, but it's okay. Again, I'm just going to go for, yeah, there we go, getting a couple of double stacks there. Look at that, we're up to 23 now for the bonus. And again, the object for me is this. It's very, very simple. I'd like to try to keep the amount of bonus stacks that we get on the Hammer Ring 4 times the amount of times that has gone by. So I think that seems like a pretty reasonable baseline there. I don't know how true that is going to be, but we're just starting. Like I said, it's a new way to play Falstad. I don't know where the butcher is. I don't know if he's gonna be sitting. I don't know if he's sitting in this bush or not. More like the busher. It's actually in the mid lane right now. I forgot to use the second activation there on the boomerang, and that's okay. Again, I don't expect to kill Diablo outright here, but if I get a chance to, I will. There we go. You got to see the activation of the boomerang. So next tribute is up, and we should definitely take this one. We're a level up on our enemy team. I think that late game, we probably have a much better team fight than the enemy team does, although, of course, we need our team to actually be here. So I'm not going to fly on in until I know that the rest of my team is going in. Otherwise, I'm just going to sit back and kind of get my XP, man. That's all I'm doing. That's all I'm doing. And yeah, I don't know where our team is, but they're not going for the tribute, and that's all right. I'm not gonna force it. If they're not gonna go for it, then I'm going to just do my own thing down here. Not being an anti-team player, my team is dictating how I play. That's how I'm going to justify that. Level 10, going to go for the Hinterlands Blast again. In my opinion, the better of the two heroics. Again, just my opinion, especially if you're going for a all-out Falstad build, caster build, if you will. Hinterlands Blast does a ton of damage at range. Very, very close. Oh, a nice haymaker there by Murden. Butcher is completely foobar. And I missed the Hinterlands Blast. I was actually going for Li Ming there. I don't know if she saw it coming, but a little bit of a waste. That's okay. Luckily, the Hinterlands Blast is on a relatively short cooldown at 2 minutes. Murky's going to die up top, and as long as the enemy team doesn't get any fort for this tribute cycle, I will be content. I guess going to hit Lightning Rod down here just to, again, keep Diablo honest. Yeah, so the enemy team, at the end of all things, did not really gain anything. They gained a level. Nice ancestral healing there by Rhaegar. I'm just going to keep pushing this bottom lane back. And basically now I'm going to kind of shift focus into just making sure that I'm dominating this lane and bullying Diablo out of this lane. And Diablo kind of screwing up there. You never really want to lead off with Shadow Charge. You want to always lead off with Overpower. And then turn around and try to slam them into the wall with Shadow Charge. There we go. You see how much damage I'm able to get. So, again, I do have to be careful here because, yeah, there we go. It's another three-man gank down here on the bot. There's the second activation. You see how much damage we're able to do, and right now we're sitting at almost 40 stacks. So, yeah, we're above the four times threshold. Maybe I should increase that threshold to five. Five times the amount of time that's been allotted here. Enemy team going into a really, really awful position. I'm going to go right for Lee, not for Li Ming, but right for Lieutenant Morales. Butcher was taken out. Oh, Murden completely whiffed. I'm going to go back and get some mana. One thing I will say is that Falstad is indeed, he does suffer from having a mana deficiency whenever he does something that isn't a right-click build. So again, I'm going to just fly down here. Of course, Falstad is permanently mounted, but he does have a travel, which is fly. This is the ability you can use once every 40 seconds, 45 seconds. That's right, I'm going for it, Diablo. I'm going to just keep you honest. This is my lane. So level 13, I am going to be going for Thunderstrikes. Thunderstrikes is going to increase the amount of damage that Lightning Rod does provide as long as I hit the same strike. I think it's 15 extra damage on every subsequent strike. So this is going to do a lot of damage to Diablo. And he ends up using Lightning Breath, which didn't really go so well for him. That's okay. He actually canceled the Hinterlands Blast, which good on you for that. But I'm trying to goad him into going into the turret. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. That's okay. So I'm just going to go right back to getting right back to work here leveling. I mean, like, we haven't really gone for the tribute. I don't know if we're going to start now. My fly is up, so I will be able to fly in if our team decides to do that. So I'm going to go ahead and fly on in here, and let's see if we can take our first tribute. I want to get away from Li Ming because that's going to do a ton of damage to me. Again, Lightning Rod's still active even if I get stunned. I'm going to go ahead and go for the Hinterlands Blast because I see Murky landing the... he did land the Octograb here. Murky is going to get taken out. Oh, so much damage with the hidden weapon, with Boomerang, I should say. Because Li Ming ended up getting the group up there with the S of Johan, and I was able to hit the activation of the Boomerang. So, Thrall with the Troll Sundering. I don't even care about that, Thrall. So, beautiful job there by Li Ming to get the little pile up going, and then I was able to slam the door shut with the second activation of the Boomerang. So we are finally able to get our very first tribute here. I don't know where Rhaegar's going. Again, we don't really benefit too much of sticking in the same lane right now. We need to be spreading out, we need to be taking down multiple forts. We need to basically just keep making ourselves get more and more lead. I mean, the best StarCraft II adage ever said that I've ever heard was "win ahead, get more ahead," and that is true in every sense of the word, especially in Heroes of the Storm. But really, you can apply that to pretty much anything that you do in competitive gaming. Awesome indeed here. Level 16, I am going to be going for Hammer Time, and that's basically going to allow me to have a little bit of a stun on my basic attack. First basic attack will stun the target that is affected by the hammering flow. And I've surprisingly been able to land a decent amount of my hammerings, my skill shots. I do see Diablo's coming down here, so I'm going to be a little bit careful. Actually, they're all coming this way, so I'm going to back the heck on up. There's Tailwind kicking in. Tailwind, by the way, is Falstad's trait, which gives me increased movement speed after not taking any damage for more than 6 seconds. So again, with Hinterlands Blast, I'm going to be able to keep Diablo off of here. This is not really the best way for me to get this. Oh, I was able to get a lot of damage. I don't even have Hinterlands Blast up, actually. And I guess we're just not going to go for it. So, all right. Well, I was able to get a lot of stacks off of my Gathering Storm, I guess. That's the positive there. And again, just absolutely raffle stomping these stacks here. I saw Li Ming coming from a mile away. Enemy team with a full court press down bottom, but I'm able to hold them off. Again, you really don't want to mess with Falstad at range. A lot of people tend to underestimate the amount of damage that Falstad can really do, and that comes back to hurt you. Our team was able to take the top Grave Golem, which is good. I'm going to go ahead and start pushing this bot lane pretty darn hard, because the enemy team is going to have to be relegated to try to defend against the Skull Golem. That means they're not going to be down here, and if they do, I have more enough confidence in my ability to take down this lane. This is what pretty much a standard split push would look like here. We have a big push in one lane, and then we're going to be off pushing in the second lane, also known as a split push. Herp a derp a derp a derp. That's my herp a derp charge, by the way. Herp a derp a derp a derp a derp charge. That'd be a great t-shirt. By the way, new t-shirts for the mosh pit coming very, very soon to a theater near you. Hint, hint, wink, wink. And I will say that it is very Heroes of the Storm related. More specifically, it's Solo Q Silliness related. So yeah, we're going to get our first actual series shirt instead of it just being a lame old Invicta shirt. It's not lame. None of my shirts. I have enjoyed all my shirts. I don't want to make the people who purchase the shirt feel like, oh, he thinks that these shirts are lame. No, they're actually really cool. If I wasn't happy with any of these, with any of the shirts, I wouldn't have sold them. But I think that a lot of people are going to really enjoy the third round of Invicta shirts that'll be coming up in the month of March. Yeah, we're just going to steadily just split push over here. I'm going to fly up to the mid, however, because we do have a little bit of a team fight going on. Now let's see if we can. Whoa! Where are you going, Hammering? Where are you going, buddy? Land the Hinterlands Blast here. There's the Sundering landing only on Li Ming. Nice job by Li Ming to use teleport to get away. There we go. Look how much damage I was able to deal just to Li Ming. That was just from the Hammerang alone. I'm going to go tap the fountain real quick just because it's right here, and plus I need mana. So there's the Octograb there. I was able to land the Hammerang on top of pretty much everyone that was there. Unfortunately, the Octograb really didn't do too much. Beautiful shot there by Li Ming Pillar. There's exactly what I wanted to do. I wanted to get the Hammerang, the Boomerang specifically, to land on Li Ming, and that's exactly what happened. There's the stun. I'm going to see if I can get in front of Lieutenant Morales just to body block her and slow her down. She's not going anywhere, so we end up getting a full team wipe. Wow, what an incredible job that was by everyone on our team. Level 20, I'm going to be going for the Nexus Frenzy just because it's just so good. You don't not take Nexus Frenzy. I don't care what build you're going for Falstad. You don't not take Nexus Frenzy. Nexus Frenzy, of course, increases the amount of basic attack damage, also increases the attack speed of said basic attacks. So beautiful team fight up by four levels at this point. And I gotta say, I mean, Caster Falstad seems pretty darn good. I don't think I've played him optimally here, but I do think that I played him well enough. So there is the Ancestral Healing there on Rhaegar, or not Rhaegar, on Murden. I actually didn't even see the lightning come, or the Disintegrate casted by Li Ming, because it was actually blocked by the Lightning Breath of Diablo. I'm going to go back and go get some mana. So we're able to turn this one around, and we get a huge win out of taking out that huge team fight. And with our Grave Golem coming back up in about a minute, it's going to be pretty good. So far, all systems are go. We haven't even lost a single fort yet, and the enemy team has lost everything, including one keep. Murky trying to get away from Butcher. Ah, I don't care about Murky. I care, but I don't care. Murky dies to the Butcher. There's worse things that can happen in the game. Right now, 19-8. Taking a look at our stats really quickly here. So much damage by Li Ming. Li Ming has been absolutely terrorizing the enemy team. Although I have been pretty much harassing this Diablo all day today as well. So I do need to be a little bit careful about overextending here. I was actually able to hit Diablo with that. I'm going to back away because right now I feel everything encroaching on me. Thrall looking like he still wants to kind of pursue it, and I'm going to let him. If I can pull the enemy team out of position by coming after me, that's completely fine. Because that means that they're all focusing on me, and they're not caring about my team. Here comes Diablo chasing me down, man. Diablo wants a piece of Falstad. He's not going to be able to get it. And here's my favorite thing about Falstad. I was in one lane, now I'm going to be in another. And Falstad can be everywhere you don't want him to be. Oh, I was able to get Lieutenant Morales. Unfortunately, was not able to get the kill. There we go. There's the backswing on the Hammerang. And down goes Lieutenant Morales. Here comes Thrall actually coming out from the side. That was a terrible Sundering for us as he stunned everybody inside the Chain Lightning. Apparently, apparently Rhaegar didn't get the Ancestral Healing off. I apologize, Rhaegar. I thought you did. So, a little bit of a blunder there as we kind of overextended. It started off good, but unfortunately, the sundering that came out from Thrall kind of screwed everybody up right there. And just like that, the enemy team trying to make a little bit of a comeback here, but they still got about a fortnight to go. I don't even know what that means, but apparently they have 2 weeks to go for something. Wow. Li Ming using Disintegrate just to kill one non-egged Murky, although she does know where the egg is, apparently. Murden going after Li Ming here. He ends up using Rewind. Get him, Murden. Yeah, there you go. Even use the Haymaker to kill Li Ming. You kill our Murky, you're gonna die. Now, unfortunately, I don't know. That would actually be a pretty interesting fight. One-on-one Murden versus Butcher. I think Butcher would actually win that. And a 3-on-1, Murden's definitely not gonna win. Hopefully he can get away, though. Run, Murden, run! Run your dwarven legs off. Unfortunately, he doesn't have Avatar, so he's not gonna be able to escape, but we know that they're gonna be going for the Grave Golem here. And we basically need Murky for this. So there's Disintegrate doing a little bit of a spot for us. I can actually use my Hammerang as well to spot. And I don't have Hinterland's Blast up yet. Rhaegar actually got stunned again by the Sundering. Oh yeah, there we go. There's the second activation on the Boomerang. And that was a bad one. I didn't agree with it, I just got impatient with it. Look how much damage we're able to get on the second activation. So good, man. And again, we're still pursuing this here. Safeguard has worn off on the Butcher, but we need to be going for Morales. Yeah, there goes Morales. Great job by Murky landing the auto grab. Butcher knows that they're not going to be able to... They're really not going to be able to initiate here with me and Li Ming and Murky here. So down goes the Butcher. It's only going to be me versus Li Ming and Diablo. I mean, Li Ming did come back up, though. I have a feeling Diablo's probably swinging around to the side, so I'm going to actually back off here and go heal up and get some mana. If they get the third tribute, it's not the end of the world. We can easily stop them. Especially with them being without their DPS and without their support. Well, one of their DPS, anyway. Murden. Oh, what a nice job it was! Again, the Arcane Orb just dominating. And these team fights, Li Ming is strong, man. I'm pretty sure everyone kind of knew that, though. No reason not to go after the Night Camp here. Right now, our stack's sitting at 78, so I fell a little bit off of our benchmark number of 4 times, but again, I have been fighting a whole lot. I'll take out this Night Camp and hopefully not die. Okay. Gonna go back and then we're gonna try this again. We were able to take down the Grave Golem. I'm actually gonna go back up top here and defend against this huge wave. So we've got a Night Camp that's gonna be going up middle. We do have the Grave Golem going top as well. The enemy team is just now finally pushing the bot lane, which I feel like they should have been doing this entire time. Fort lost. So we did lose one fort, and we've already lost the top fort up top, but the enemy team only has one keep, and it's about to be assaulted by a very angry Grave Golem. Yeah, I'm gonna go help my team take down the Ogre Camp real quick. There we go. Now, the enemy team going for their own Grave Golem here would spell doom for their entire team if they tried to do it, especially with our Grave Golem pushing the top. So we are going to be hopefully able to take down this other Grave Golem, and that should be our ticket home. Yeah, we just have so much damage now. Even not going after an AA build, Falstaff Steel does so much damage. He Steel does it. So all we gotta do now is pretty much push with our Grave Golem, and that hopefully should be it. As long as we don't bungle up the team fight here. I don't know where Murky is. Diablo gonna try to act as a little bit of interference here. I'm more concerned about where Thrall is. Here comes the Hinterland Blast, landing on pretty much three of the enemy team. I'm gonna harass Butcher here and stay on him. Yeah, there he goes. Down goes the Butcher, Sundering, not in time. Down goes Diablo as well. Gonna go turn around and go back on Thrall. Nice Ancestral Healing landing on Murden right at the very end. And I'm basically just gonna go right after Lieutenant Morales here. Actually, the boom didn't go off nearly in time anyway, but I think that's going to be it. So we are gonna be able to get a clean win here. Everything definitely hinged around that 5-0 team wipe. Final total gonna be 28-14. I'll leave this build down below. Falstad, check him out. He's super duper strong and super duper fun. Thank you for watching, everyone. Until next time, so long, everybody!